Welcome back to Tuesdays with Puddinghead, everyone. And I am playing against Red Dice Diaries this week. I am playing the Adramalek Warlock in the upper left, and Red Dice is playing the Wizard in the lower right. And this is going to be quite the game. I am actually going to try and play Pentagram this game. It's going to be super crazy. This is kind of an older book. It has a couple of tweaks that I would make to it now that Elementalist Academy is out and Druid Academy is out, but whatever. We're going to give it a go. And if I die, I die in a blaze of fire. All right. The first thing I'm going to do is double crystal. He is probably going to gate first turn, which is going to be super annoying for me. Tell him I'm ready. Ready. If he does not gate, I am going to quick cast my crystal just in case he does gate. Nah, he's going to gate. So this is going to be super fun. He's going to have hordes of little critters, and I'm going to have to deal with them. So I think my plan is going to be to do some ranged guys first, and then right before I'm about to engage, I'm going to drop Pentagram. And against a wizard is like the worst mage to do that against, but we'll see if it ends up paying off. We'll see what he does. He's probably gonna harmonize his gate. Yeah, harmonize gate. Cool. The gate functions if it has three or more on it. So if I move two, is it worth moving two here is the question. Because if I move two and do nothing, will I be able to burn him down fast enough? Because this... that would be super interesting. That's not how I'm supposed to play. But that might actually be incredibly interesting. I can... Man. I kind of want to do it. I kind of want to move too. And see what he does. Because he's going to have 14 mana next turn, which is enough to cast something reasonably strong. But I bet he panics. Well, doesn't panic, but he assumes I'm just going to curse him up and light him up. But if I... if I pentagram and then fireball... I'll try it. Maybe I'll try it next time. Because my spawn point is not going to come out till later. And it's much more fragile than his is. So he might just come in and attack it. Let's see. Arcane creatures don't have ethereal. But he does have lightning bolts, so pentagram might actually be a bad choice this game. And if that's the case, then I need to get up to I'll just go double buddy, I guess. I can go Vampirus and Hellion or something. Yeah, we'll just do this. We'll do this. I hate wizards. I've said this before, but I hate wizards. They have, their stuff is just too strong. Alright. Let's do this. So I go first this round. And I think I'm gonna do... a Hawkeye. And... a Vampire. And then, let's see, Hawkeye Vampire will give me 18. Next turn, I'll have 13, which should be enough to do a... Akira's Favor and a Skeleton. And then I can put on some armor the next turn. So, yep. That's the plan. I don't like playing into the gate. Lightning Raptor, huh? Well, that guy does zero damage right now. Feels like he's got time for a Lightning Raptor. Well, we'll do it. I would also put a Demonic Bloodlust in here. Probably. Just to make something stronger. Gate. 14 life. All right, I need to go. So I'm gonna go. Vampirus. Enchant, enchant. I need to get a couple of threats on the board so that when I pentagram, he's still got to deal with the threats. Enchant. Okay. It's fine. It's fine. No quicks for me. Oh, I already did my quick. No upkeeps for me. Maybe I move and double enchant this turn. So I can give myself... let's do a Kiro's Favor and maybe we'll put on some armor. Or I could cast a smaller creature, but I kind of want to get up closer, I think, so that I can push something out of range. Hmm. Or I could just Skeleton Archer. But if we keep staring at each other across this field, then he's going to get more powerful than me, I think. So I need to get up a little bit closer. We could Cloak of Shadows. Maybe Cloak of Shadows. Or we could just double enchant. Maybe do that. We can Kira's Favor and nullify this turn. He's not deploying. Interesting. Right. I don't need a quick cast either. Guarding with the raptor. We will do this. And this. Done. Armor. Wise choice. Vampire twice. Not quick from him, huh? Interesting. Yep. Alright. So much mana on his gate. Can have it. Take the mana. Don't care. This turn, I think I bet he has a Gorgon Archer coming out this turn. Or a jelly. Gorgon Archer or a jelly. What if I force push? Is it the right turn to be doing that, though? No, it's not the right turn for Pentagram. I think we cast Skeletal Archer. We could cast Flaming Hellion, that would work too. If that's a Gorgon Archer, how do I want to deal with it? Answer is I don't know. I could force push my vampire. We have a guarding raptor in that zone, so that doesn't work. Could get messed up here. There's only two dice on the raptor. Not too concerned about that. I think Let me try and pop his nullify with a marked for death. And we'll cast the creature on our turn. Yeah, mark for death and force push. We'll save a little bit of mana. And the next turn, maybe we can light some things up. Alright, here we go. Gorgon Archer? Nope, Hydra. Nice. Alright. Definitely don't want to be dealing with that. Okay. We are going to move in here. And attempt to cast on the mage. Yep, nullify. Okay, it's fine. Take damage and attack the mage. Generating dice rolls. That's fine. 5 damage, take 5 damage. Gate. Actually, 1 mana because the nullify got rid of the mark for death. Didn't resolve. And he's going to move away. Yep. Wonder if that's a shrink. No cure's favor for me this game. Wonder what that is. Chant of Rage, probably. Darkfin Hydra. Shield. I'm gonna bet that's a Chant of Rage. So the question is, how do I want to deal with the Chant of Rage right now? And I think the answer is gonna be another force push. If I can push the Hydra up here, I can move in and at least attack the raptor. if that's a chant of rage, what do I need to do here? Could reverse attack this turn. Could get an afflicted demon out this turn. All sorts of things I could do this turn. Afflicted demon might be nice. So if I can get a couple of weeks off on that Hydra. I think I also want to try Pentagram. Leaves me with 12, so I could fireball something. Or I could even surging wave something. Surging wave might be a good choice. What if I did pentagram and surging wave? Pentagram is different creature is attacked and damaged. Okay. So we can do that. Now, how do I deal with the chant of rage if I do it this way? Just hope that she survives. She's probably not going to survive if he wants to take her out. So he's got 16 mana, he's got a deploy coming, probably a gremlin. And during deploy, he's going to reveal Chant of Rage. Watch it. Watch. No deploys. During first quick cast, he's going to reveal Chant of Rage. First quick cast. Yeah, Rust. Oh, okay. Okay, Rust is fine. Teleport the Hydra. Teleport the Vampirus. Okay. It's fine. Triple strike. Generating dice rolls, 2 damage, 1 damage. Oof. That's what he's been wanting. Okay, so it averages out. He took 8 damage out of 9 dice. That's pretty average. This guy rolls 3 dice with a stagger chance. So I'm going to oh my gosh, 5 blanks. Are you kidding me? Max damage, min damage. Okay. Well, that's probably game. Hawkeye. Earth Belt, of course. Alright. Well, dead vampire in one round. No healing, no damage, and so much damage from the stupid raptor. If I pull this out, this is going to be amazing. Alright, we're going to pull an afflicted demon out. I think that's going to cost me 7 of my own, so I have 10. And I'm going to poison blood the wizard. Actually, I'm not going to worry about poison blooding the wizard right now. I'm going to... Boy, that vampire was supposed to be around still. We can seeking dispel his enchantment. Because he's probably got a nullify coming. And then put his shield on. So I need to keep doing damage. I think I need to take this turn to do some damage. Firestream the raptor. Okay. 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 Get an afflicted demon in here. Put gremlin in here. Okay. Pass quick. Seeking to spell a nullify. He does have enough mana to teleport me into the triple strike. I do not want to be teleported into the triple strike. Thank you very much. If I move, he's going to teleport. He can teleport the Hydra too. I'll just wait and see what he does. Okay. All right. So much damage. Good grief. 10 damage on 6 dice. 13 damage on 9 dice. This is super awesome. Alright. Yeah. Yeah. Quite a game. There is no reason he shouldn't win this. Ugh. So irritating. So incredibly irritating. Really needs to be an agony in this book. His move first. So I'm going to put he activates his Volteric Shield again. Yep, he does. All right. Well, at least I'm mana draining him too each turn. Stupid triple striking Hydra is a problem. What do we want to cast out of this pentagram? Actually, I could explode the. Can I explode that thing? It cost me 12. If I get an imp out, 15. I have 2 mana left. I'd like some lesser teleports in here too. Let's get a Flaming Hellion out here. Let's prep a force push. It's going to be 11, 6. I have 3 more. A force push and a. We might tangle on me in here. So I might need to teleport this round. All right. No place for him, huh? Boom. No first quick cast. Tanglevine. Jinx? Yeah, it's probably a Jinx. See, this is why I don't put armor on, because he just rolls crits all the time. Oh, I can't pass. here. Now I'm done. And now the question is, what do I do? Just gonna move up here and go on card. Lightning bolted. This is just so much that I should have just run at him, I think, earlier. If I had moved two and then gone seeking to spell mark for death, I might have been able to burn him down. I think I should have tried to do that. So maybe I'll concede this one, or maybe we'll play another one and we'll see if that works out. Alright, no creature actions, no final quick casts. I can't summon anything this round. I'm so close to dead. I wonder if I... Needs more enfeeble. I think we're going to reverse attack and mark for death this round. Oh, reverse attack. I don't know if that's actually going to happen. Because I'm probably going to get Seeking Dispelled again. I might have a nullify on me too. Ugh. I hate wizards. I hate wizards so much. If I can roll a really good drain on this guy. The worst that could happen is I die. So I can't deploy. Gate of Altari is so stupid. It's so stupid. I should have just been like, yep, I'm gonna melt your face now. Okay. First quick cast. I'm not going to quick cast. I don't need to. Alright, we're going to... do this. Oops. Come on. Get 5. Well, that sucks. move. And that gets rid of the daze and the guard. Put this on you. Done. And here comes the teleport and the triple strike. Yep. Third teleport. Yep. Wizards, man. Wizards. And he's gonna get 15 damage on this. Watch. There's two. There's six. It's eight. So he can't get 15 damage. Alright. 12 damage on 9 dice. Love it. Love it. Lightning bolt. Arc lightning. Acid ball. Okay. Well, statistically dead. Yep. Good game. Round game. Stop giving me notifications. Shut up. All right. Is what happens when the dice go crazy and when I don't realize I'm the aggro. Alright, we are in game two and I am prepped the exact same way to pretend I'm gonna play it like it last time, right? Okay, I don't have a quick cast. Boom. So now he can't spawn anything. And we're going to see if this actually works. Now, first quick cast, he is probably going to cast Nullify. So I need to be able to deal with that. Think I'm gonna put, I don't know how many nullifies he has, but I think he has at least two because he's a wizard. So I can Seeking Dispel. Seeking Dispel and Mark for Death. He might prep Nullify and Seeking Dispel, which would be absolutely hilarious. To nullify. Yep, nullify. And I'm gonna reveal it just in case he preps Seeking Dispel. Seeking Dispel. that's his action. So this turn, he's probably going to dispel this. So I'm going to... Let's see, he's got 24 mana, so he can get a Hydra out. Dispelling this costs 6, so maybe he can't get a Hydra out. Upkeep, not upkeep. So he's got initiative. What is the right thing to do here? I think the right thing to do here is Hawkeye and Hellion. 2 and 9 rather than 0 and 9 and fire damage. So yeah, we're gonna Hawkeye and Hellion. Blue Gremlin, okay. Interesting. So he's keeping his mana. Alright. He gets quick. He's gonna dispel. No, he's got elemental cloak. Okay, that's fine. I'm not gonna quick. There's the nullify. Okay. I know what I'm doing next turn. No, oh, Rhino Hide. Okay. That's cool. Two mana on the gate. And now we need to go into overdrive. So I'm going to pick explode. And he puts a shield on, which totally makes sense, right? Dispel the mark for death. We'll see. Alright. This is kind of exciting to be going fast and furious this way. Gargoyle. Okay. Cool. That's not a problem. Defend. Nullify. Okay. That's cool. I'm gonna force. No. We're gonna do. That target's a mage. That target's a mage. Interesting. That's a nullify. That's not good for me. I want to get rid of this. Perhaps I prepped poorly. I could always explode this turn, though. I was force push the mage. I think I'm gonna do that. No, let's do this. We'll try and force push. Nullify. On him. No, five dice. Because you got flame plus one for a curse. Good grief. My stupid dice. Token to the Wizard. Oof. Ouch. And he dodges. No damage both rounds. Okay. Cool. Alright. And it is his turn. As a guarding wizard. I think I'm gonna ignite. And rust. His turn. No, it's his turn. And I have 17 mana. I think we should Firebrand Imp. It's only got 6 health though. It's his turn. First action is going to be to guard with this guy, probably. Out here. Volteric Shield, man. Volteric Shield. So I want to do burn stacking. Hmm. already do that next turn. I need to get the rust off. I've got two of them. It's fine. Is that really the best choice this turn? Firestream and rust. That's fine. Alright. First quick. No first quick, huh? There's a guard. That's fine. Target's the rust. Okay. I think we're still gonna go in here and melee attack you. There's some damage. Holy cow. Well, that was quite a roll for that demon. Six dice to do. We only did four damage to the wizard, but whatever. See if we can do some damage to this guy. Wow. So many blanks. Leave that there. Move the burn. Yep. Flaming Hellion's gonna die. Or not. Burns do more damage to him. Only two damage. Gosh, two burns rolled blanks? Seriously? He's probably going to put his shield on. He puts a shield on, okay. I mean, why not fireball? And poison blood. Fireball and poison blood. That's the plan. A good shot. That was a really good shot. What was that? Yep, okay, that's fine. Okay, where am I going? I have to go back here. Creature actions. Stagnation. Average. Average. Yep, regrowth. Isn't a dead hellion right now. All right. During his upkeep. Let's see if he burns. Burn, baby, burn. Burn, baby, burn. Save up for a drain life here. Ooh, he did continue to burn. Dang, that's nice. That is nice. Alright, this guy is probably dead. I'm gonna go with force push fireball or flame blast. He's gonna dispel the poison blood this turn. He's got 11 mana. Even the wardstone doesn't stop him from doing that. Push this turn. He's got a bunch of teleports. I don't think he's gonna go away from his gargoyle though, because the gargoyle is protecting him right now. So, man, if I could get a rise again off on this guy, be pretty cool, but I don't think that's gonna work out for me. Alright, so I get 9 mana. I need to spend a minimal amount of mana this turn. So I'm thinking force push and nullify. Poison blood or just flame blast. Flame Blast is good. Force Push Flame Blast, that's 8. That gives me enough to Fire Stream and Drain Life next turn. Alright, let's see how this goes. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom. And deploy. He's gonna kill the Hellion. Or maybe not. Maybe he's gonna nullify himself. Not dead yet. Is he going to intercept this? Nice. Sweet cup and cakes. Well, if this does go live, that was Tuesdays with Puddinhead. Thanks for watching, everybody. Bye.